Hello and welcome to my first video. In this video, I'll show you how to create a simple event system for Unity. You will need a version of Unity. In my case, I'm using 2021.2, a base understanding of the Unity game engine and C# programming language. We will be able to achieve this by having our scripts, in this case the enemy and UI, communicate with the event system that they want to subscribe to the event on player death. Now when our player invokes the on player death event, the event system will tell all subscribers, in our case the enemy and UI, to invoke their subscribe function. In this case our enemy will dance and the UI will display the game over screen. So here we are in the Unity editor, and as you can see, I've already got a basic scene set up and ready to go. We have a player object with the player script, an enemy object with the enemy script, and a UI object with the UI script. What we want to achieve is to have our player send a message to the enemy and UI that the player has died. We want to do this avoiding references by leveraging C# actions, delegates, and events. Jumping into our event script, we're going to remove the start and update function and minor behaviour inheritance. Next, we're going to import the system namespace to give us access to C# actions. And finally, we're going to create a public static action for the on player death event that our enemy and UI can subscribe to. Now in our enemy script, we can remove the start and update functions, create the on enable and on disable functions, and create the dance function that will display a debug log in our console of the object's name with the text is dancing, which will be called when our event is invoked. Then we're going to jump into our onEnable and subscribe the dance function to the onPlayerDeath event, while unsubscribing in our onDisable function. Now we're going to repeat the process for the UI, replace the start and update functions with onEnable and onDisable, and create the void activate game over screen. We're going to need a reference to our game over screen game object to activate, so let's create a reference at the top of our script. Now in the activate game over screen function, we can enable our game object with setActive. Jumping back to our onEnable, we can subscribe to our onPlayerDeath event and unsubscribe to it in our onDisable function. Now in our player script, we're going to simulate the player's death by pressing the spacebar. In our update function, use the simple if statement to check when the user presses the spacebar key. Then invoke the action with events.onPlayerDeath?invoke. I use the ternary operator here to check if something is subscribed to the event. As invoking an event with no subscribers will give you a null reference. Back into Unity, we're going to make sure that we set our game over screen reference in the inspector. Now when we play the scene and press the spacebar, the game over screen will activate and you will see our dance log in the console. If we disable the enemy game object, we will no longer get our debug log, as we subscribe to it in our onEnable. But also we do not get any errors, as our player does not care who or what is subscribed to the onPlayerDeath action. Likewise, if we create another enemy, we will get two dancing logs, as both enemies are now subscribed to the event. And that is the power of this event system. As our player has no knowledge of what is and isn't subscribed to the onPlayerDeath event, we can add and remove systems without worrying about null reference errors. Now let's create an event that will send data from one class to the other. To do this, we can still use our actions, but when we declare the action, we use the angled brackets and insert the data type we want to pass for our event. I am creating an event for when the score is updated. In this case, I'm sending an int value to the UI system to update our score. With our event set up, let's jump into our UI script and add a function that needs to have the same parameters as our action, otherwise we will get an error. For the purpose of this demo, I'm going to debug the score value that we are sending. Make sure to subscribe and unsubscribe in the onEnable and onDisable functions. Finally, we're going to jump back into our player class and invoke the onScoreUpdated action while passing an int value for our new score. Back in Unity, when we enter the play mode and press the spacebar key, we can see our on-player death event still firing, while also showing the score debug from our UI system displaying the new score value we get from the player. Now we're going to work on an event that will return a value. This can be useful for getting specific values from another script. To do this, we're going to use the func delegate. When declaring a func, you will use the anchored brackets to define the return value type. Unlike the action where the anchored brackets define the input, the brackets here will determine the type the delegate will return. For this example, I'm going to create a func that returns a float and use it to get the player's health from the player script and send it to the UI. Now jumping back to our player script, we need to create a variable for our use case. I will create a simple health float and set it to 100. Then we want to make a return function that returns our health float. I'm going to simply call this getPlayerHealth. Finally, we want to subscribe and unsubscribe in our onEnable and onDisable functions. Jumping to our UI script, we're going to create an update function that will grab the health float from our player script. First, let's create an if statement to grab the health value when we press the H key. Unlike an action, we need to add an if statement to check when the health value is not null. With that in place, we can create a local variable to store our health value and set it by calling our func event. However, because this float can be null, we need to cast it down to the regular float type. Finally, I created a debug log to show us getting the float value. With this done, we can jump back into the editor and start a play session. When I press the H key, we see that our UI is debugging the health float from our player's script. Now we're going to create an alternative type of event that's useful when we need to pass several parameters at once. We can do this by using actions and adding all the variables we want to pass. However, this method can be hard to read when using many different variables, so you won't be able to tell which ones go where just by looking at it. As you can see, when I try to call this action, I get a list of all the variable types I need to send, but no information on which ones go in which order. To get around this, we're going to use delegates and events paired with a static function to call the event. To do this, let's create a delegate that specifies the types of variables we want to send with a default name for each variable. For my example, I'm sending a string for the player's name, an int for their damage, a float for their health, another int for their XP, and finally a string for their class name. Then we're going to create a static event that is of the same type as the delegate. Be sure to make sure the event and delegate share the same level of accessibility. If we try to call this event currently, we will get an error. This is because events can only be called from the class they are declared in. As you can see from this tooltip, an event can only appear on the left-hand side of a plus equals or minus equals, for example, when subscribing, unless used within the script it is declared in. To get by this, we can create a static void that shares the same parameters as our delegate. And because this is a regular function, we can give the parameters a default name. Now in the body of our function, we can invoke the event, allowing us to call the event from anywhere in our code base. Jumping into our player script, we can call our raiseOnUpdatePlayerStats function to invoke the event, and we can see the tooltip appearing, showing us which values go in which order. Finally, we can go to our UI script and add a function to subscribe to this event. And in the onEnable and onDisable, we can add our subscription calls. After copying the parameters from our delegate, we can debug the values to show the event working inside of Unity. Jumping back into Unity, when we start a play session and press the space bar, we now get a bunch of debug logs showing all the values that we sent through our delegate event method. Now to recap, we can see we created an action that takes no parameters, an action that takes a single parameter, a func that returns a variable, and a delegate event system that allows for greater readability when invoking more complicated events. If you got this far, thank you for watching. Being my first video, this tutorial is probably a little rough around the edges, but it's been a great learning experience for myself. Trying to explain so much information in a concise way has been a challenge. I'm always looking to improve, so if you have feedback or just found the video helpful, drop a comment down below as I'd love to hear what you have to say. If you want to see more, hit the subscribe button, as I have plans to do more videos based on Unity in the future. But for now though, I'll see you next time.